Amen. In John 21, if you weren't here last night, thank all of you that pressed your way out last night, that hung out with us. Amen. We had a wonderful time here up in the house. Amen. I know it's the first day of the year. Y'all thought y'all was going to get out at 11:15, but it ain't happening. Not yet, but we will be moving soon. I heard people got some special New Year's stuff. You know, my mama has been kind of losing weight. Now she's been getting up. This woman is eating. She gets up in the middle of the night, goes into the kitchen, fixing her own meals. So I said, Mom, what are you fixing this weekend? Chitlins. I said, Ida, she lives in Cincinnati. I said, out of all the stuff you would fix, why some chitlins? Because I want some chitlins. I guess for some cultures, I'm sorry, chitterlings is that New Year's meal. That rope back there, they know something about all that stuff and cow tongue and all that stuff over here. I'm going to find me some birds somewhere. All right. So whatever you're feasting on when you get home today for your New Year's resolution, we got some interesting stuff. How many of y'all did laundry last night before midnight turned? No dirty clothes in the house? Come on, we got a few of them. What else? No dirty dishes. Should be some black eyed peas going on today.
What?
You hear that? I didn't know collard greens represented money. Collard greens. All right, what else? Huh? Blessed. Collard greens? Two? Chicken. See, chicken works all the time. You know, we can have chicken in heaven. Cornbread. Sauerkraut. Some kind of pork. Some kind of coleslaw to go with that. Chitterlings. My mother said she got a 10-pound bucket. She said it ain't even 10 pounds anymore. Well, see, by the time you clean them, it probably ain't going to be nothing no more. If we go leave that low. We going to leave that low. I'm making y'all hungry, ain't it? All right. So John chapter 21, this is one of those nuggets that we were talking about just last night that I just want to dig into a little bit. And then I want, if you leave with anything today, this first Sunday of the year, I want you to just bask in the thought of God in me is bigger than I let him. God in me is bigger than I allow him to be. He really is. Unrealized potential, unrealized strength is what I just want to talk to you about this year. Last night we did some counting out of John chapter 21. And this is right after the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Of course, he's visited his disciples and he's shown up a couple of times just at the end of chapter 20. He has shown up and he walks through the wall and Thomas is there and he has this conversation with Thomas. And he's making several appearances to the disciples. But right after this encounter at the end of John 20, Peter decides that he wants to go fishing. Amen. All right. And one thing that I like about the turn of the year, even the songs that we ministered this morning, there's not a thing that you can do to fix 2016. Amen. Right. Not a thing that you can do about it. None of that journey you could change or you can alter. It is what it is. You know, so one of the songs that we were ministering, I won't go back, okay? And some of me, I have to tell myself I need to quit looking back, yes. Right? But there's something in Peter that thinks that after walking with the Lord all this time, he can just go back and pick up his fishing gig. Take it, it ain't gonna work like that no more, baby. You in another day, you're in another season. And the things that may have worked well for you in 2016, God's about to do some changing. We called it shifting last night. Okay, so what's interesting about the text, and I just want to just highlight a couple of things, is that while they're out fishing, Jesus is already on the shore fixing dinner. Did you notice that in the text? He's got bread, he's got fish sandwiches going on the shore. And they're out there fishing. So the provision that they're seeking is already in play before they get back to shore. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You're thinking about it and it's already being set up. Yeah, y'all not listening to me. I saw some supernatural things over the last few days, and I'm believing that this is going to be the year that we're going to step up into some places that we have not had to sweat to get there.
Amen.
You know, it's kind of one of those signature things that God did with the children of Israel. He said, now look, I know that you've been down here in this oppression 400 years, and they had lost the taste, they had lost the feel, they had lost the aspiration that anything was ever going to be different for them. And I can understand that. I mean, you've been holding on to a word, holding on to a word, holding on to a word, and finally, after a while, it just ain't going to happen. God's not going to do it. And by the time Moses comes down and tell the people, look, God's going to do this thing, it's that they couldn't hear him. Right? So you know what God said? Now, I'm just going to make the package a little bit sweeter. I'm going to send you into a house that you didn't have to build. I'm going to let you eat at some vineyards that you didn't have to plant. You're going to drink of a well that you didn't have to. And I mean, it goes on and on and on. So all the time that you were incarcerated or thought you were being held down, I was moving some other people on your behalf to set you up so all you had to do was walk in and occupy. I'm telling you that this year, some of us in this room are just going to walk up into it and occupy it. And guess what? You're not even going to be qualified. They just going to say, we I'm talking to somebody in the room. You just going to walk up and occupy. Wow. The provision, say with me, the provision is already in place. So this is what Jesus says to them, and it says, I'm in John 21, verse 5, Jesus said, do you have any meat? And they answered, no. Now, understand, they've been working or fishing all night and caught nothing. Now, just because there's nothing in your basket doesn't mean there's nothing going on. Oh, come on, somebody just open up your purse. Said, and you know what? I don't see much down in there, but it don't mean ain't nothing going on. Oh no, it's not going to be a purse service. It's not going to be a purse service. I just need you to look. Brothers, pull your wallet out. I said, look, I don't see a whole lot going in there, but it don't mean I don't have some provision. See, provision is bigger than what you may feel in your wallet. It's bigger than a credit card. It's bigger than a check. Provision is connected to him who can speak something out of nothing.
Amen.
Now understand, Jesus is asking them if they have any meat, and the meat was already on the shore. So why is he asking the question? Because he wants us to understand that you've got more than what you realize. Don't measure your productivity by what's in your hand. You've got more than what you see. Anybody in the room? So this is what he says to them. You need the cash on that. Look how it reads here. All right? He says, cash your net on the right side of the street.
On the right side.
Amen.
Maybe I've been looking over here, but I need to get on the right side.
Amen.
Huh? Maybe I've been looking for it to come. You know how we get. God said he's going to do it, and we're looking for it to come a certain way. What if God said, I just need you to get on the right side? Ask your neighbor. The preacher wants to know, are you on the right side? What do you mean, the right side? You mean physically I'm in the right location? Now, what if I'm still in doubt, and God said, I need you to get to that faith level. Faith says that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. And I've been diligently seeking him. I do something. Uh-oh. And then, so watch this. And it says, now they cast therefore, and now they were not able to draw it in for the multitude of fishes. Now, why would God allow this supernatural miracle to take place when they went out for meat and the meat's already on the shore? See, I believe that we're about to step into a place of what I call supernatural faith. God is about to do some things for us just because we ask. Just because we ask. So here they are. They're out fishing, and they've got, the record comes back, they have 153 fish that they didn't need. Right? So why would God give us things that we didn't need? I think, first of all, to convince us that he can do it. I'm telling you, if we would just get about God's business, God's already handling ours.
Good point.
He's already handling our business.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
All right, so let me keep reading in case you don't believe me. It said, therefore the disciples whom Jesus loved said, Peter, that's the Lord. Right? All right, when Peter heard it was the Lord, he had to put some clothes on because the Bible said he was naked. He cast himself into the sea, and they had to send another ship to help them drag the net of fishes. Right? And as soon as they were come to the land, they saw what? And what? Okay, so Jesus got the fish, the bread, the tartar sauce for the sandwich. Right? And here they come with this other supply. And you know what Jesus said to them about the other? Bring of the fish which you have now caught. They didn't need the fish for themselves. Right? So what they drew in was for somebody else. Doesn't that say to you that God's going to take care of you? Doesn't that say to you that God's got you? I mean, right down to the meal was already prepared. You out working trying to get something. And God said, but I've got the meal already spread out. So the provision is already in place. Amen. That's what I want to tell you today. All right. Now, a couple more. I want you to look at Exodus chapter 4. So this is for the people that still want to make some excuses in 2017 about, I don't know yet. I don't know yet. So here is God telling Moses all these wonderful things that he's going to do and tell the people this and tell the people this. And Moses just straight up and said, chapter 4 of Exodus 1, and Moses answered, the Lord said, they ain't gonna believe it. Right? Nor are they gonna listen to my voice, nor are they gonna believe that I had an encounter with you. Right? So you know what God's response was? Well, what's in your head? I can use what you already have to convince the people that I've spoken to you. Alright? So there's something that you already got that God wants to use to convince the people that God said it.
Okay.
I'm talking to us this morning. All right. So you don't have to have God just download this big huge supernatural manifestation. God said, I can use the little that you got right now. Yes. Yes. Philippians chapter 2 and verse 13. For it is God that worketh in us both to do and to will of his good pleasure. What about Philippians 4:13? I can do all things. Right? I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. So God is empowering us this year to use and pay attention to what we've already got. All right. And remember that there is a supernatural divine push behind me that's encouraging me and challenging me to move out of my place of comfort. Say with me, the provision is already in motion. I need to pay attention. I need to make sure that I'm on the right side. And I need to prepare myself to catch some big fish. Big fish. Say with me, some big fish. You hear that, Ron and Christy? We got to get some big fish this year. Some big fish. And why not you? Why can't God supernaturally put you in the path of somebody that's a big fish? Well, what do you mean by big fish? You mean they got a lot of money, they got a lot of property? No. What if they're in position to influence a whole team of individuals? What if your presence and your conversation with that one is going to start a chain reaction in that whole neighborhood? Well, Jesus did with a woman that had an ugly reputation. John chapter 4, she had a terrible reputation. But when she went back and told him she found a man, everybody listened to her. And the Bible says they came to Jesus and said, now that we've heard you, we know that you are who you say you are. And they went back to the woman and said, we've talked to the man ourselves. But she is the one that planted the seed for the whole revival of Samaria in Acts chapter 8. Tell me, won't he do it through you? What if God is positioning you to get a big fish? Well, I can't talk to that individual. I can't minister. Well, what's in your hand? Why can't you say? Amen. Come on your feet. Happy New Year. On your feet.